This is the world's first 2-kilometer skyscraper, a building so tall it makes the Burj Khalifa look small, and almost twice the height of the Jeddah Tower, the current record contender. But how do you even begin to build something this extreme in one of the hottest, harshest places on Earth? Saudi Arabia is changing, faster than almost any other country in the world. Over the past decade, the kingdom has launched some of the largest construction projects in history. Neom, a new mega region on the Red Sea coast. Qiddiya, an entertainment capital outside Riyadh. And the Jeddah Tower, which, when finished, will become the world's first kilometer-high skyscraper. All of this is part of Vision 2030, the government's plan to reduce reliance on oil and pivot towards tourism, business, and global trade. At the core of this vision are landmark projects, buildings and megastructures designed to grab headlines, attract investors, and place Saudi Arabia firmly on the map of global innovation. Now, in Riyadh, the most ambitious of them all is taking shape, Rise Tower. Designed by HKS Architects, this colossal building is planned to soar 2,000 meters into the desert sky. That's 678 floors of offices, luxury hotels, apartments, restaurants, and sky gardens, forming a vertical city within a single structure. At the very top, observation decks would let visitors see across the desert for up to 80 kilometers. It would be more than a skyscraper. It would be a new global landmark. But to build something like this, engineers are facing challenges no one has ever solved before. Rise Tower would stand at twice the height of the Burj Khalifa. It would be taller than three Empire State Buildings stacked end to end. Its base would cover an area larger than 20 football fields, and its total floor area would equal that of a mid-sized city. If completed, it would hold the record for the world's tallest building, highest occupied floor, longest lift journey, and highest observation deck. The scale is almost hard to imagine. Think about this. An elevator ride from the bottom to the top would take over a full minute at maximum speed. And from the upper floors, you'd be looking down on airplanes coming in to land at Riyadh's airport. This is construction at a scale humanity has never attempted before. It all begins underground. For a tower this tall, foundations are everything. Engineers first excavate a massive pit, dozens of meters deep, carving into Riyadh's rocky desert terrain. Into this, they drive thousands of steel-reinforced piles, anchoring the tower securely into the bedrock. Then comes the concrete raft foundation, a slab so vast it would be one of the largest ever poured. Hundreds of thousands of cubic meters of concrete, reinforced with steel, form the platform on which the entire skyscraper stands. From here, the tower's superstructure begins its climb. A central reinforced concrete core houses lifts, stairwells, and essential services. Around this, steel outriggers tie into giant perimeter columns, distributing the building's immense load across the foundation. The outer profile isn't straight. Instead, it tapers and twists as it rises, an aerodynamic form designed to reduce wind resistance. Because at 2 kilometers high, wind isn't just a problem. It's the biggest challenge of all. At the summit, gusts can exert thousands of tons of pressure. If left unchecked, the building would sway meters from side to side. To solve this, engineers use a combination of aerodynamic shaping and internal technology. The tower's narrowing profile channels wind smoothly around it, and inside, enormous tuned mass dampers, giant steel pendulums weighing hundreds of tons, counteract movement, keeping the building stable. Vertical transportation is another problem. Conventional steel cables simply can't reach 2 kilometers without snapping under their own weight. So the design calls for magnetic levitation lifts. Instead of cables, these use powerful magnets to glide up and down tracks, like maglev trains turned vertical. They can also move horizontally, creating a network of sky lobbies that break the building into neighborhoods. Construction itself would push machinery to the limit. Specialized self-climbing cranes would scale the building as it rose, lifting enormous steel sections into place. At peak, the site would employ more than 20,000 workers, operating in shifts around the clock. Concrete would be pumped hundreds of meters into the sky using high-pressure lines, while prefabricated steel modules would arrive daily in a constant stream of logistics. This isn't just building a tower, it's building a city in the sky. But the desert brings its own problems. Temperatures in Riyadh often reach 50 degrees Celsius. At that heat, concrete risks setting too fast and cracking. To solve this, engineers cool the mix with chilled water and liquid nitrogen, and often pour foundations at night when temperatures are lower. Then there's dust. Fine desert sand blows constantly, coating equipment, clogging filters, and grinding down machinery. Cranes and lifts must be sealed against the elements, while cleaning crews work non-stop just to keep surfaces operable. The tower's sheer energy demand is another obstacle. Air conditioning, lifts, lighting, and water systems together would consume electricity equal to a small city. Massive substations are required just to power the building. And then there's cost. Estimates put the project at more than $20 billion. That's more than it cost to build the entire Dubai metro system. Securing financing on this scale isn't simple. It requires backing from global investors, government support, and flawless supply chains. That's why critics have questioned whether Rise Tower will ever be finished. The Jeddah Tower, itself only half the height, has faced repeated delays and remains unfinished years after construction began. Some argue that instead of a single landmark, Saudi Arabia should focus on more distributed, sustainable projects. Others say that finished or not, megastructures like Rise Tower serve their purpose simply by capturing attention. But what's clear is this. Saudi Arabia wants to build big, and projects like this are designed to make the world take notice. If Rise Tower is completed, it will change the world's perception of what's possible in construction. It would set new benchmarks in architecture, engineering, and vertical living. It could transform Riyadh into a global business hub, attracting companies, residents, and millions of tourists. Technologies developed for the towers, from maglev lifts to new concrete mixes and wind damping systems, could influence skyscraper design worldwide. And beyond the technical, it would stand as a symbol. A modern counterpart to the Great Pyramids, the Eiffel Tower, or the Empire State Building. A statement that humans are still pushing limits, higher, faster, and bolder than ever before. But it also raises questions. Should we keep building taller and taller? Or should we focus instead on making cities more livable, sustainable, and equitable? For Saudi Arabia, the answer is both. Projects like Rise Tower are about prestige and identity, but they're also about pushing boundaries, sparking innovation, and shaping the future of construction. Rise Tower may become the boldest skyscraper ever attempted. Whether it's completed or not, it shows one thing. The race to build higher is only just beginning.